Hi everyone, it's the Math Sorcerer here with Chegg. In this video, we're going to discuss rates of change in the natural and social sciences. Let's do this example. Height of a projectile that is shot upward is S of t equals 3 plus 20t minus 4.9t squared, where S is in meters and t is in seconds. Part A, find the velocity after 3 seconds. Let's go ahead and work through it. Solution. So we are given the position function, which is S of t equals 3 plus 20t minus 4.9t squared. And we're asked to find the velocity after 3 seconds. Well, if you have a position function and you take the derivative, you're going to get the velocity function. So all we have to do in this problem is take the derivative of S and plug in 3. So S prime of t is equal to derivative of 3 is 0 because it's a constant. And then 20t, its derivative is 20 because the derivative of t is 1. For this last piece, we can use the power rule. We can bring down the 2. We get minus 9.8. We subtract 1 from the t, from the exponent, so we get t to the first. And that would be the velocity function. So if we plug in value of t, it will give us the velocity after t seconds. So we want it after 3 seconds. So S prime of 3 is equal to, we have 20 minus 9.8, but instead of t now, we're using 3. So S prime of 3 is approximately equal to negative 9.4. Let's think about the units here. So everything here is in meters, and the time is in seconds, so it's going to be meters per second. So at this point, because we have a negative velocity, it says the projectile is already on its way down at 3 seconds. Part B, when does the projectile reach its maximum height? This is a fun question. Solution. So if we throw something up in the air, we have to think about what happens when it reaches its maximum height. So if I have the ground here and I throw something up in the air, it's gonna look like this. And so this is where the maximum height occurs. So what happens there? Well, the velocity is 0. So the maximum height will occur when there's no velocity. So to find out when that happens, we'll take our velocity function, which is S prime of t equal to 20 minus 9.8t, and we're going to set it equal to 0. All right, now we just have to solve this for t. So I'll subtract the 20 from both sides. So minus 20 minus 20, we have negative 9.8t equals minus 20. And then just divide by negative 9.8, divide by negative 9.8. So we end up with t equals approximately 2 seconds. So after about 2 seconds, this projectile will reach its maximum height, which makes sense because in the previous example, we know that after 3 seconds, it has a negative velocity. So it's already on its way down after 3 seconds. Let's do part C. Part C, what is the maximum height? Let's work through this one. Solution. So we know that the maximum height occurs when t is about 2 seconds. So to find the maximum height, we have to use our position function. Recall that our position function was S of t equals 3 plus 20t minus 4.9t squared. So this tells us the height after t seconds. So all we have to do to find the maximum is plug in 2 because we know that's when the max occurs. We get 3 plus 20 times 2 minus 4.9 times 2 squared. So S of 2, you put this in your calculator, it's approximately equal to 23.4, and the units were meters. So that would be the maximum height. Let's just go over the whole problem really quickly one more time to make sure you got the ideas down, because this is a nice problem that is very typical. So we're told a projectile is shot upward and we're given this position function s of t, which is 3 plus 20t minus 4.9t squared. Part A wanted the velocity after 3 seconds. So the key point is that whenever you have a position function, the derivative is always going to be the velocity function. So in this case, we just took the derivative, which is our velocity function, and we plugged in 3 and we got negative 9.4. That was somewhat enlightening because it was a negative answer and we're shooting something up in the air. So why would it be negative unless it's already on its way down at 3 seconds? Which part B actually confirmed. Part B says, when does the projectile reach its maximum height? So if this yellow line is the ground and you shoot something up, it's going to go up, 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 and eventually it'll stop just for a brief second and then start coming back down. That brief moment when it stops, that's when the velocity is zero. So to find out that value of t, what we did was we took our velocity function, which was s prime of t equals 20 minus 9.8t, and set it equal to zero and solved for t. We got approximately 2 seconds. Part C wanted the maximum height. Well, to find the height, we simply use our position function, which was given at the beginning of the problem. So all we do is plug in 2, we get approximately 23.4 meters. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to check out more videos on Chegg. Good luck.